I'd like to show you some different kinds of rerailers. You've already seen the ones built into the track and you're pretty familiar with them. You just kind of run your car across them and they rerail your car like that. Pretty common. But I was doing a video the other day and somebody noticed me using one of these rerailing ramps. You got one by Kato. You've got a short ramp by Microtrains. You have the tall ramp by Microtrains, which you can use on a curve. And you have this low profile mid-range ramp by Rick's Products. So we'll give these ramps a try and I'll show you how they work. You can also find them in HO and other scales too, but because I'm N scale, we happen to have N scale ramps and you'll have a quick look at them. So one of the easiest ones to use is one by Kato. It is a low profile ramp. As we can see, pretty low profile, but it's just you set it down, push it down on the track. What I like to do is it's got a wide groove where the car can sit in. I kind of push it to one side and it just rides on down just like that. Very easy to use. And that one. Simple to use. The other ones work about the same way. The only difference is on the Rick's product, it has this little groove in it. But it still works the same way as everything else. As you can see, we'll just do a couple. So it just is really convenient to use these, just like that. The only different one you see is the one by Microtrains, a high profile ramp right here. And what this does, you can use it on a curve. So on a piece of curve track, as you can see, it sits down and the curve track actually runs underneath. Works on curve sections. I don't have it hooked up, but you should get the general idea. The taller ramp works on curves, but it does have its issue is it's a steep incline and a lot of times the trip pins actually catch on the ramp itself and make it a little bit harder to rerail the cars. But most of the time it works pretty well. Longer cars are where it becomes an issue. If you're railing an 89-foot car, something like that, what happens is it gets caught here and it'll actually lift it up and sometimes not get it railed correctly onto the track. That is about the only drawback to the tall ramp. Right now I think one of the best ones is the Kato one and the lower profile Microtrains ramps. The Rick's product works just as well. So at this point it's just kind of personal preference on what you want to use. And I don't have all the details on what's in HO scale and above, but they are available. So when you find yourself needing to rerail a car and there's not an available rerailer on your layout, or like me, you just get a little bit better at rerailing N scale cars. Not that hard. If you have any questions or comments or anything else you'd like to see or comment on this video, post it down below and I will read those and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Oh, by the way, don't forget, we have the Down and Dirty Weathering Contest coming up. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and comment down below. And if you find any of this stuff interesting, there is an Amazon link down below. Go check it out. So for now, stay frosty, my friends. Oh, right there is a playlist to the Down and Dirty Contest. Might as well click it, unless you want to watch me rerail cars. You're still here? Click on the box!